Welcome at our large-scale silvo arable agroforestry system here at the experimental fields of Wageningen University in Lelystad. So here we have our 15 hectares agroforestry experiment in which we are mostly researching and looking at the effects of the tree rows on the crops that are growing next to them. We're mostly curious to find out how the positive effects of the trees and the negative effects of trees will balance out in this context here in the open polder landscape in Flevoland. In this experiment, we're actually working with two different fields, and on both fields we have three tree lines or tree rows. And the unique thing is that we have a different distance between the tree rows in this experiment. So we're working with the smallest distance of 50 meters between the tree lines up to 100 and a reference of 150 meters to see how these distances affect the crop growth. Each tree line consists of two tree rows. We have a dense row of fast-growing trees here on this side to quickly establish a windbreak. We have elder, willow, poplar and elm, and these trees were planted in 2021. On the other side, next to the fast-growing windbreak, we have a row of hazelnuts for nut production. They were planted 1 year later, and the aim is that they will in time take over the windbreak function. Each year we grow two different crops that rotate within the organic rotation on this farm. This year we're growing oats on this field and potatoes on the other fields. In earlier years we've also grown beans, peas, onions, carrots and cereals. In this experiment we're mostly looking at the windbreak effect of the trees in an open landscape, mostly in the light of climate change, because we know that reduced wind speed will reduce evaporation of the soil and crops and thereby improve the water availability for these crops so they can grow better in periods of drought. And to find out how this works, we are doing different kinds of monitoring. We're monitoring the crop growth and the yields, but we're also looking at the soil moisture, relative humidity and the wind speed, for example. Another effect of having the tree lines here is that we create a habitat for biodiversity and natural predators to establish, and we expect that from the tree lines they will migrate into the fields, into the crops to do more natural pest control. We know that under certain climatic circumstances there might also be potential negative effects in an agroforestry system like this. One example, obviously, which is often mentioned, is the competition between trees and crops for example, water and light. In this experiment we try to keep this limited by keeping the size of the trees limited to a certain height and also by pruning the roots so their competition underground is limited to a certain extent. Another potential negative effect is that the reduced wind speed will cause more moist conditions in the crop, which might favor the spread of certain fungal diseases like Phytophthora and potato, for example. In our design we try to keep the lower layer of the trees a bit more open to allow for certain wind to pass through it, to at least create some wind. Well, with a young agroforestry experiment like this, obviously there's still a lot to wait for. But some interesting things that we've seen from the first year is that in our biodiversity monitoring, we've seen a higher species richness within the tree rows compared to the fields. And how this might also benefit the crop system is, for example, last year in the faba beans, we saw a lower pressure of aphids because of a higher presence of natural predators in the system. And next to that, obviously, we've learned a lot of practical lessons about how to operate such a system. We are super curious to see what this experiment is going to show us and learn us about agroforestry in the coming years. feel free and feel welcome to visit the experiment or to do some of your research projects in our experiment here. There's a lot more to find out about agroforestry.